Janine, Bryn, B-R-Y-N. The name Bryn, where did it come from?
When I was pregnant, it was the World Cup in Wales, and my grandfather was Welsh, so I went over there to visit family, and we couldn't afford the ticket to go and watch the game at the stadium, but South Africa was playing Wales on the day that I was there, and it was all very exciting. I wasn't quite sure who I should be supporting, and this opera singer came onto the field, and his name was Bryn Tafelda, and I wanted a Welsh name because my grandfather was Welsh, and I just thought, Bryn, awesome name. And so that was the song. I don't know if you want to hear
it. Yeah, I want to hear it.
Okay,
yeah,
I've got it somewhere on my phone. He was a kind person. He just, to me, that word just encompasses Bryn. And he played guitar, and he was artistic and creative, and he painted, and he was talented.
You know, Bryn was a water boy. He loved swimming, his marine life saving. He enjoyed the sea, and being out in the open like that. Everybody loved Bryn. He made friends very quickly, and he was the life of any party that he was at. He was someone that definitely had that presence wherever he was. If anything, a son who loved children. So I was going to get a grandson one day.
He was playing water polo, and his coach said to him, you know, you're feeling okay? And he said, no, I'm just, you know, feeling terrible. But he still went to the gym afterwards. His six-pack, very important.
Janine got the phone call from my son, Kian, to say, come quickly, something's wrong with Bryn. He trains hard, so, you know, in the gym, so we thought that, well, you know, he might have fainted or something. But whilst we were driving to the gym, we got the second phone call to say, you better come quickly, he hasn't woken up.
We got there, and I ran in, and I saw Bryn lying on the floor. He was blue.
The trauma of what you are seeing was not real in front of me, if I can say. I just felt that I'm witnessing something that was outside of me, and was not part of my immediate reaction to kiss him on his forehead, kiss his hand, hold him, you know.
It's such a shock. You've got this healthy 17-year-old boy who goes to the gym every day and he's pumping iron and doing his thing, you know. And then the next thing, he's lying on the floor and your brain just doesn't take it in. I was sitting in the ambulance and I knew he was gone. I could feel it. So I went to the doctors and I said, can you test him to see if, you know, we need to see if he's brainstem dead, because I don't want to be sitting here for a week thinking he's going to survive and then having this massive disappointment when we find out that he isn't.
And we then got word later on that no, there was no... there was no hope in saving this burst aneurysm in Bryn's head. I died that night myself.
I was the one that forced the decision that night at the hospital. And you know, when you've got a husband and a son who are not quite on board yet, I was left thinking, am I this callous person who's just giving up my 17-year-old's organs? And, you know, and there were all his friends standing outside the door, and I thought, what the hell do these young guys think of me, that I'm just going, right, Bryn dropped down in the gym and today we're going to already look at donating his organs.
I had a bond with my son, in fact, both my sons, where we made fires together. I make a fire every single night that I can in remembrance of my son. It's my therapy. The idea that my days go by and I haven't thought of Bryn, it is my absolute terror that I will forget my son. But for now, I have his picture in my visor when I drive. I have my house to surround me with all my pictures of Bryn. And I have my fire and I have my other son, Kian. So no, it hasn't got any easier.
Ek het geweet ek het 'n probleem, toe het ek gegaan vir om 'n polis uit te neem. Toe sê my huisdokter vir my, my hart klop nie lekker nie. Doet my hart 17% funksie gehad.
Sê vir my, as jy die hart so voel klop in jou borskas, wat se gedagtes kom by jou op? As jy voel hier klop die hart,
ek het 'n verskillike gedankbaarheid. Ek dink elke dag aan daai seun en sy familie. Elke dag. Dit is iets wat ek nooit in my lewe sal vergeet nie. Die beste van alles was, is om te weet dat daar nog mense is wat omgee.
It is still good to know that there's someone that's living because of Bryn and because of what he did. And it's made a difference to a lot of people.
Haar se hart word goed gebruik.
Ja.
En ek dink haar seun sal ook trots wees op my wat sy hart gekry het. En ek kan nie sê hoe jammer ek is dat iemand nou moes doodgegaan het dat ek 'n hart moes gekry het nie.
En as jy graag al wil ontmoet, sal ek
ons laat baie graag wil ontmoet. Ek wil nie met haar op 'n selfoon of 'n ding SMS nie, ek wil haar persoonlik sien.
Ek wil baie graag ontmoet en vir haar sê hoe dankbaar ons is.
I was sitting on a stoop exactly like now, and there I was talking to this man who received your son's heart. And he was so incredibly thankful. He has a new life ahead of himself, and he loves children. That's all I can tell you, and he wants to come and meet you people.
It would be my absolute pleasure to meet a recipient of Bryn. I hug, and I would love to hug that man.
Sê vir my, hoe voel julle oor vandag?
Man, ek voel goed oor vandag. Ek dink dit gaan 'n mooi dag wees vandag. Ek sien uit daarna om die mense te ontmoet.
Ons het hulle mos gesien op die ons weet hoe hulle lyk.
Ja.
Nou, hulle lyk baie aangenaam. So ek seker of van ons sal goed oor die weg kom.
Ja.
Ek hoop regtig so.
Hulle is ook maar baie senuweeagtig om julle te ontmoet.
Senuweeagtig?
Heeltemal 'n traumatiese ervaring vir hulle ook.
Ja, natuurlik.
Want hier is jy,
ja,
in jou lyf
is hulle seun
se hart. Wat klop en vir jou laat opstaan en beweeg en lewe.
Ja, nee.
En hierdie ongelooflike jong hart wat jy gekry het in die lease on life wat iets ongeloofliks is, né?
Ja, nee.
Moments of Truth is now playing out, almost like a Bach symphony, leading us to a new dawn, a new era. They are now only a few steps apart.
Hello.
Martin.
Yeah, hello.
Very nice to meet you.
Hello. Hello. I'm the name of I feel I know you already. Thank you.
Thank you for looking after your family so much.
I told myself I'm not going to get emotional because he's the one that normally cries his eyes out.
Hey, Martin.
This is the hug that I've wanted the most.
This is the hug I've wanted the most.
Yeah.
Martin, you make my life better for it now. And I know I can hug my son. Yeah. A physical hug like this means everything to me. Baie dankie.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for looking after your family and for my family too. We are humbled to meet you. And we really are.
Yeah, well.
The strength that you have shown and what we saw on TV just doesn't make up for what I see today. Thank you.
Oh, so come over here.
Thanks for looking after your family and for giving us hope. That's what we live on.
Okay.
We know that our boy has done something wonderful.
And we know, obviously, from watching you on TV, in your 15 minutes of fame, that you're grateful as well. And it means so much, you know, to us too. When you said on TV, I can't remember the wording, but you said,
you know, that you get up and you think of us every day and you think about our boy. And that to me means so much because, you know, you don't want your child to be forgotten. You don't want it to just be the heart. And as much as I go, yeah, it's just a piece of machinery that keeps, you know, kept Bryn alive and now it's keeping you alive. But as Jan says, you know, there's more to it than that.
Ek groei elke dag meer en meer met Bryn se hart.
It's wonderful. Yeah. You know that you savor every day and you make sure that every day you give thanks. And we can only be humbled and too grateful for that, really. So Martin, you're a man amongst men.
Toe ek wakker word na die hartoopplanting, toe julle kom besoek die volgende aand, toe ek wakker word, toe sê ek vir hulle, maar hulle het nog niks gedoen nie, man. Maar ek het geen pyn gehad. Ek gedoog ek gaan nou wakker word met 'n verskriklike pyn. Ek het geen pyn. Ek sê nee man, mense het nog niks gedoen nie man. Hulle sê nee man, maak oop hierso. Jesus, ek maak hier oop, is net pleisters en goed.
Can we see you, Scott?
Yeah, you can see.
No way, is it?
Nice man.
And that's just like 2.5 years.
I didn't feel a heartbeat.
Yeah, you feel it. Strong.
Oh man.
I love you guys.
Oh, thank you.
I'm just so thank glad you that you're here.
For us as well. Because we've, you know, I live a very quiet life, Martin. Mm-hmm. And I love to make fires, and my fires keep me bonded. So the next time you make a fire, know that I'm making a fire with you same time, okay?
No, I'm also fire. If I can braai, braai.
Oh, good mate.
You braai. What do you do?
Yes,
sometimes 100%. We somehow put on a fire without doing anything. Just
that's every night I do. Every single night I can. That's right. But you know, there's so many people that are putting their arms around us at this moment in time, Martin, and we feel that love. We feel that, you know, we can talk to people and talk to people, but to physically meet my boy's heart in you. Yeah. That's there's my boy there.
You're now like part of my heart.
My favorite saying with my son at night, I would say, I love you, my boy. He says, I love you too, Dad. And I'd say, I love you more, my boy. You know, Jan, I can only say from Janine and I, thank you for caring. Honoring our boy the way that you have is huge in our life. It really has been. And I can, you know, we can go forward knowing that Bryn has been honored. He's made an impact. He didn't die for nothing.
As this series is coming to an end, my thoughts and wishes are drifting around the amazing people that made my life worth living. They are the people that touch my soul, my heart, with memories that will accompany me to the last hours of my life. Where to begin now? Marlon Moodley, a young man, an aristocratic soul that made me think so differently about life and death. A man who I am sure walked straight into the heavenly sphere of existence. In his world, he trod his path so gently. Dear Veronica, I will continue thinking of you. Aisha, your heart came just too late. I was so convinced that you have the talent to become an actress. Your reflecting dark eyes would have touched a nation. I salute Nadir for his compassionate caring for his beloved wife. And who is the sublime Mrs. Stone? The woman who gave a kidney to her neighbor's boy, Amiruddin. Mrs. Stone, you are a big, big jewel in the crown of heroes. I feel so humble and blessed to have met you and your very exceptional family. Ja, Christine Stone. Ek het nog iets om te sê. Ek wil my oë vir 'n oomblik toemaak om die warmte weer te voel wat ek saam met jou en jou familie ervaar het. Dit is min wat 'n mens so tuis voel in so 'n hegte familie. Amiruddin, ek hoop jy het 'n heerlike verjaarsdag gehad die 22ste November. Ek het gedink aan jou. Ek hoop ek sien jou gou-gou weer. En die kleurvolle Fatima. Ook 'n ontdekking op hierdie oorplantingsreis van my. Jy versorg Amiruddin met onvoorwaardelike liefde. And then look van harder. I believe you are well. Do you remember? I looked like Father Christmas to you at the Red Cross Hospital. I sing songs of happiness about all the babies who were given a second chance in life and the pediatric surgeons who made it possible. All of you are angels who share our burdens and make them lighter. You make life worth living. And I'm still walking the talk with Vuyo. He's doing well at the moment in the capable care of Professor Natusi at the Groteskier Hospital in Cape Town. We will complete Vuyo's book in time to come. It must be soon. We have to remember that time waits for nobody. My dearest Marilyn, I know you are not well and you are listed for a lung transplant. In spirit, we are waiting with you. Jana Breitenbach, poele van blou, blou oor, wat my so raak. Ek weet jou pad is moeilik en die drag is swaar. Maar ons help jou dra so goed as wat ons kan. Nikki, yes, yes. You're still fighting the fight with new lungs. Lungs that yet to come to action. Thoughts from all of us surrounding you.